Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, let's look at what are the steps involved to create a new site in Sitecore. So there are mainly three steps. One is adding a config file, adding a site definition in the configuration using config files, and add a host entry for the port. And as well as the last one is add website binding in IIS for the which website we want to add this new site URL. So let's quickly get started. Before going to the steps, let's look at what all the sites are configured for this site. If you remember from the previous videos, this is what we have installed, Sitecore 10.1. And if you can quickly navigate to control panel, and it will open in administrator tools. Then check the configuration, and you can click on show config. There would be ton of configuration files associated with the one Sitecore installation, but this show config will help a lot, like merging all the configuration files, so we can see at a single place all the settings involved in that Sitecore instance. In this, let's quickly check sites. So under sites, so if you see, a lot of sites are there. Okay, here a lot of sites are there. This is where you will see all the site entries. Ignore other things, mainly focus on the site name equal to website. So this is a site which by default, whenever you install Sitecore, it will show. So where it will be like, if you were, as we spoke before, yeah, this is a content delivery kind of environment where you see, or even the CM also we can see, where you see a home page. So this is running, or this is what you call resolving based on the site node. So like this, if you want to add another site, this kind of a configuration we need to add first. So let's quickly see. For that, rather than going and adding, we can just go to the inetpub where we have installed. So inetpub www root and sc10 sc. So this is where we have installed our Sitecore site. You can go to app config. This is where app config folder contains all the configuration files, and you can go to include examples. There are a lot of examples which are already given by Sitecore, but by default all of these are disabled. We can just enable and as use it. So let's quickly find site definition. So this is where site definition is. We want to use this as a installation, as a site definition, rather than creating from the scratch again. Let's copy this, and if you remember, this is a solution we have created connecting to that Sitecore instance. So you can create a new folder. We'll try to match the deploy location. So app config, include, and just create a project. So I just pasted that file here, but before that, let's rename it. It cannot, example means it is disabled. Anything after config, it will be disabled. So we need to make sure that extension is .config. Then means when we deploy it, it would be enabled. So this is a site definition. Let's collapse it for now. So if you see here, they have already given the purpose. This includes file adds to a new site definition. To enable this, rename this. So this is inserted before that. Okay, this is a simple configuration where we are focusing on site name maybe we'll put sidecar demo. Sidecar demo site, and let's keep virtual folder, physical folder. We have not created any folders in our instance. Focus mainly on these two, root path and start item. So, okay, I mean, from IIS we got the request, sidecar, sorry. From the IIS, the host entry, whatever we have, I mean, whenever with the incoming URL, it tries to come to the site and okay, it resolved here. From where does it need to serve the home page? From where need to start? That is what this two are important. Sidecar content as well as home. This is what you are seeing also when you are, just let me quickly go to content editor. Whenever you are doing loading this home page, where exactly does it resolving? So if you go to content editor, let it load. Yeah, check sidecar content and home. Home is the one which is serving that content, and that is a page. So how does it, I mean, it is a page item. So how does it know? It knows sidecar and content are the, sorry, sidecar and content are the root path. So till here it goes, it will not be part of the URL. And start item is a home. So home we have part. So it's a combining both this, it will try to resolve sidecar content and slash home. So if you go here, which is what this sidecar, this is what it is, sidecar content and home. If you combine root path plus start item. So let's keep this as it is for now. And what we need to add is, we are trying to add a new entry, right? For that, you need to add hostname, sorry, equal to, let's add sidecar demo dot local. So hostname is incoming URL. Whenever in the browser user hits this URL in the browser, it will come here, then sidecar uses this hostname to resolve that URL. Okay, this is what the incoming URL is, and this is what the site is matching, site configuration is matching for that. So for that we are adding sidecar demo dot local. If you need a, and there are a lot of other attributes are there, not going to cover everything, just a main are these three, and you have a target hostname and other cache settings, language, a lot of other. There is a good explanation here itself in the document, I mean in the configuration files. If you go to here, sites, above sites, you have a, like very lengthy commented text which explains all the attributes and what is the use of those attributes individual. So if you see here, mode, name of the site, host name, target host name, port, and root path and start item, language, which database, so like n number of settings are there. So for now we will just use the basic settings. And mainly notice here, we did discuss about content databases. So which database? Database equal to web. So that means this site reads the content, reads this root path and start item from the web database. In the local, in the developer environment, I mean in the local, sometimes we just test with the master also. That time you can put it in master, but remember that is only for the local testing purpose or development purpose. So if you want to change that, you can come here and change to master, but let's keep it this till now. Now the next step is add a host entry. You can add in n number of ways, but I'm a big fan of sidecar instance manager tool, much easier. So it will give you this kind of a small utility where you can go to bundle tools and just open host editor. It will open new host entries. So you can add it here, which is what we had given, sidecar demo dot local. So check this host name and make it here as well. So, okay. If you are not having this tool, go to this path. See Windows System 32 drivers and etc. Sorry, etc. Here you can modify this host. So you can see here, you can just make entry as I just did from the sim tool. It has come here, but you can also make an entry here if you are not having that sim or anything. So let's, the second part is completed. Third part is add website binding. So host entry is done. For website binding, well, let's go to IA settings. So here you have this website, right? For this we need to add extra binding. So go to bindings, click on it, add, just do it for the sitecode demo.local, just do it for the HTTP. Okay, close. Now if we click on it, it will not come. Let's do, because site definition is not there, so let's publish this. Already everything is there, so just publish. So build succeeded. Let's go and see where it is. Just a sec. Did it move? App config include project site definition. Okay, sorry, just a sec. Properties. Okay, copy to output directory. So now project came. So click on project and you can see site definition. Let's quickly load our show config, because it need to show our entry here, site name. So let it load. Also there is one more point here. So there is a patch before, patch after, patch instead. So what we are telling is there is a website's already exist, a website site definition. We are asking our new site definition to be before this website. That's why we are mentioning patch before. So let's quickly see, because host entry, host names, usually we will also give wildcards, different wildcards, pipe separated and everything. So ordering matters a lot. If you have a multi-site environment, a lot of sites, which one to resolve first? So but once it loads, we will be able to see here. Also let's quickly go here and open that, sorry, run that site, sitecode demo dot local. So let it run. This should show home page similar to how we are seeing this. Welcome to Sitecore. Because we are using the same start item and same root path. If we are creating multiple items, then we can point it there. Let it give a moment. Oh, okay, it's loaded. Let's see. Sitecore demo. Yeah. So if you notice, our new sitecore demo site came patch before website. So website is here, it is patched before the website, and you see the settings and host name sitecore demo.local. Let's see our sitecore demo got loaded. Yeah, so sitecore demo.local, it came in here. So that is the quickest way to create a new site, but these are not the only steps we use to create new site. I mean, these are the basic steps, but we need to take care of the caching, we need to take care of the error pages, redirects, lot of other things when we are working on a real project. So when we are working on the business requirements, we would have a lot more things, and caching, publishing, all these things involves. But these are the three main basic steps to add new site. So that's all for this video. See you next time. Thank you for watching.